guys, what's up? It's your boy Jerome, and about a year ago, I built this computer behind me, and today we're going to find out how it stacks up against a $2,500 iMac. So we're going to start by talking about what actually is in this computer build, and I'll put a list of all the parts in the description below, so if you want to build this, you'll be able to do that as well. So let's go ahead and get started. For my choice of motherboard, I went with the Gigabyte H170 Micro ATX DDR4 motherboard. Now, this is not your typical standard motherboard because it's meant to be super compact. It's supposed to be small in size, so you can fit it in a smaller case and have as compact of a build as possible. So this motherboard actually supports up to 6th gen Intel cores. It's got two DDR4 RAM slots. It's also got PCIe that supports up to 32 gigabytes per second data transfer speeds. And it also has two SATA Express connectors that support 16 gigabytes per second data transfer. Now, since I decided to put macOS on this computer, I actually had to change out the Wi-Fi Bluetooth card that was on board for a separate third-party one. I actually ended up going with the Broadcom M.2, which supports speeds up to 867 megabits per second. Now, you probably don't have internet that's faster than that, but if you do, you might want to consider going with a card that's going to get you faster speeds for this build. Unfortunately, one bad thing about this motherboard is that it does not have the ability to overclock your processor. So if you're going to be doing a lot of graphics intensive gaming or projects, this probably isn't the motherboard for you, and you're going to want to pick something else. For my choice of processor, I actually went with a 3.2 gigahertz Intel i5 quad core Skylake processor. And yes, that is a mouthful. The iMac actually has a 3.3 gigahertz quad core Skylake processor, and it can be overclocked up to 3.9 gigahertz, which, remember, this machine can't be overclocked. So in terms of solely just processor, I do have to give the edge to the iMac. Now, I did run both of these machines in Geekbench 4 just to get a benchmark of how these machines ran compared to each other. In terms of single core score, the iMac actually came in at right around 5,000, whereas the Hackintosh came in at about 4,750. Now, in terms of multi-core, again, the iMac won out at about 14,100, whereas the Hackintosh came in at right around 13,800. For RAM, I did go a little bit overboard in that I got 16 gigabytes of the Ballistic Sport LT DDR4 RAM. Now, the iMac actually only has 8 gigabytes of DDR3 RAM, but it is configurable up to 32 gigabytes. Let's go ahead and talk about the hard drive. For this build, I actually went with a 250 gigabyte Samsung 850 EVO, and actually the motherboard has space for up to two more hard drives if I ever wanted to increase my disk space. Now, the iMac does have a 2 terabyte Fusion drive, which is significantly more than this Hackintosh. But that being said, you can buy 2 terabytes for, I think, $70 or so now on Amazon. So if you wanted to increase the space on this machine to have 2 terabytes, you could do it for fairly cheap. Moving on to graphics, I actually didn't put a graphics card in this computer because I knew that I wasn't going to be doing a lot of gaming on it. And so it's actually still running the Intel Iris integrated graphics. So I'm going to have to give this round to the iMac as well, which is actually running a 2 gigabyte AMD Radeon R9 graphics card. Now let's go ahead and finish up the build. For power supply, I actually went with a 160 watt mini box Pico PSU. Honestly, 160 watts for a computer is nothing. And that's largely due to the fact that this doesn't have a graphics card. If it did, I'd have to have at least double, probably more than that, just to run this thing. For cooling, I decided to pick up a Noctua NH-L9i. And let me tell you guys, this thing is silent. It actually has its own heatsink on the bottom that's 23 millimeters thick, and the fan itself is 14 millimeters thick. So this thing's also super compact and will fit in any type of case you want to put it in. For the case, I picked up this beautiful all black, all aluminum Streamcom F1C EVO. So for the monitor, I went with a 27-inch Samsung curved LED display. I thought, why not? Let me just go ahead and get it. It'll be a cool thing to have. So I did. Now this thing can perform full HD and has a resolution of up to 1920 by 1080. But remember, the iMac does have a 5K monitor, so there's really no comparison between these two. The iMac looks absolutely stunning. Now for keyboard, I ended up going with the Bluetooth Logitech keyboard for Mac, so it does have the command and function keys built in to work with Mac OS. And for mouse, I ended up going with the Magic Trackpad 2 from Apple. No other trackpad really works that well and lets you use all the gestures other than the officially licensed Apple one. So I just bit the bullet and I said, let me go ahead and get it to finish this build. Now, as you can see, the iMac is better in almost every single category, but that being said, the iMac is still $2,500. If you take out the price of the display, the trackpad, and the keyboard, you can build this machine yourself for just under $700. So why go out and pay $2,500 when you can make the exact same machine for just under $700? Thanks for watching, guys. Hope this video helped. Hope it makes you guys want to build your own computers. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.